Good morning, students. In this class, we are going to be discussing about the new chapter, that is the third chapter in the organic chemistry, that is aldehydes, ketones, and carboxylic acids. These all together we call as a carbonyl compound. These all together we call as a carbonyl compounds because this aldehydes, ketones, carboxylic acids, these are all contains the carbonyl group in it. That's why. Is all together called as a carbonyl compound. The first we are going to be discussing about the aldehydes. When it comes to that aldehydes, these are the organic compounds. These are the carbonyl compounds. These are the carbonyl compounds. In which at least one valency of the carbonyl group, is satisfied by the hydrogen. Carbonyl group under we are going to be written like this. This is the carbonyl group. Here this we call as a carbonyl group. Means this the one valency of the carbonyl group. One valence of the carbonyl group is satisfied by the hydrogen. Are called as a aldehydes. Andre, idralli enagirutte one valency carbonyl group one valency hydrogen in the satisfy aagbeku anta compounds navu enanta karithivi andre aldehydes. That is called as a aldehydes. In this that is the function group for the aldehydes is CHO. This is the function group for the aldehydes. The function group of aldehydes is CHO. Then the general formula, generally the aldehydes we are going to be written as RCHO. If this R is nothing but alkyl R or a aryl group. It is alkyl or aryl group. This R is going to be represent. That is alkyl group agirabodu athava aryl group agirabodu. Inna idu CHO annadu function group of the aldehydes. This general formula for the aldehydes is RCHO. This is about the aldehydes. What are aldehydes in that? It is the group of these are the carbonyl compounds. In which the at least one valency of the carbonyl group is satisfied by the hydrogen. Is called as a aldehyde. The functional group of the aldehydes is CHO. That is the functional group of the aldehydes is CHO. Then we have the general formula for the aldehydes is RCHO. This R is nothing but either alkyl group or aryl group. Next, we are going to be discussing about the ketones. What are ketones? There is aldehydes, we know. Now, we are going to be discussing about the ketones. The ketones are also carbonyl compounds. These are the carbonyl compounds in which the carbonyl group, that is the carbonyl group means C double bond O. This carbonyl group is attached to the carbon atoms. Carbon atoms. Both the sides it is going to be attached to the carbons. That's called as a ketone. That is the function group of the ketone is -CO-. This is the function group of the for the ketones. This is about the function. Then general representation for the ketones is RCOR-. This is about the general formula for the ketone. Here the R and R dash are alkyl groups, alkyl group agirabodu athava aryl group agirabodu. R matte R dash enagirutte andre alkyl group agirabodu athava aryl group same way anbeku anta illa. Maybe one alkyl group one aryl agirabodu. Both are alkyl agirabodu, both are aryl agirabodu. This we call as ketones. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಲಿಡೇಟ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ವೇಲೆನ್ಸಿ ಮಾತ್ರ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಇಂದ ಕಂಪಲ್ಸರಿ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈ ಆಗಬೇಕು. ಬಟ್ ಕೀಟೋನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಕಡೆ ಬೋತ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಸ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ಫೈ ವಿತ್ ದಿ carbon atoms only, the neighboring carbon atoms. Then the next we are going to be discussing about the third group of this carbonyl compounds, that is carboxylic acids. These are the carbonyl compounds. Means in carboxylic acid, both the carbonyl group is present. Carbonyl group. And also it consists of the hydroxyl group. It consists of both carbonyl and the hydroxyl group. Therefore, this we call as a carboxylic group. This we call as a, that is a COOH. Is called as a carboxylic group. We call it the carboxylic group. Means the general representative, the functional group of the carboxylic acid is C-COOH. The general representation is RCOOH. This is the general representation of the carboxylic group. Yeah, the R is nothing but either alkyl or aryl group. Alkyl group agirbodu athava aryl group agirbodu. This is the general formula for the carboxylic acids. Then this is about the general formula for the aldehydes. Then this is the general formula for the ketones. General formula for the general representation for the ketones. Next, we are going to be discussing this about the definition of aldehydes, ketones, and the carboxylic acids. In detail, we are going to be studying one by one. Before going to that chemical and physical properties, we should study about nomenclature of the aldehydes and the ketones. Now, we'll discuss about the nomenclature. Nomenclature of the aldehydes.
CH2, CH2, CH2. Then
the name of this compound, then you should, maybe you will get a doubt. Where you should give the number? Number should start from the carbon which is contains the functional group. Means it is the one that we should get the least number. The 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, this name of this compound is butanol. That is 4 is contain. The name of this compound is butanol. Then if it is tri-chain, you will not get the any problem. If suppose it is bi-chain, that is CH3, then CH2, CH3, then CH2. Then we should name according to APC rules. That is, you should give the number first, then 1, 2, 3. If it comes like this, means 3. Then 1, 2, 3, 4. If it comes like this, in this way means you take in this way means you will get that 4. This is the longest chain. Then this the second carbon, it consisting of the methyl group. Therefore, the name of this compound is, that is 2-methyl, that is butanol. 2-methyl butanol. A butanol. That is the name of this compound. Like this only, we will take a few other examples. That is, if you are going to be taken, that is C6H5, then CH,
you take some
little bit different examples. C6H5, CH, double bond, CH, CH2. Then CH3, CH, double bond, CH, CH2. Then CHO, CH2, CH, CHO, CH3. You see these examples. That is, you see these examples, how to name these compounds. Okay? That is, you should give the number from the that is functional group. You should start from the functional group. This we are going to be taken as a 1, this we are going to be taken as a 2, this we are called as a 3. Then we won't give the number to this carbon because it's having a C6. Means it is the substituent, it is attached to the third carbon atom. Means that is the, we should name this, that is the third carbon attached to the phenyl group. Therefore, the name of this compound, it also contains the double bond. It also contains the double bond. You should concentrate on that also. Then also you should get the functional group. Therefore, the name of this compound is 3-phenyl. How many carbon atoms are there? That is 3 carbon atoms are there. Therefore, that is what we call as probe, that's right. It's consisting of the 3 carbon atoms, that's why probe means double bond is there. Therefore, in, you should get. Therefore, which carbon contains double bond? Which is attached to the double bond? Second carbon contains, that's why we are going to be taken as probe to enol. AN represents the functional group. In represented as the double bond, pro represent the number of carbon atoms in the chain, then 3-phenyl represent the, that is the substituent which is attached to the third carbon. This about the name of this compound is, the name of this compound is 3-phenyl pro 2 enol. Like it only comes to the next example. In this also it contains the double bond and the functional group. Double bond is the function group. Then you should give the number into this. 1, 2, 3, 4 functional group ide adar jothege double bond ide should concentrate how the how we are going to be given the name of number of carbon atoms in the chain is 4 therefore butene then the second carbon is attached to the double bond therefore butene 2e then aldehyde group is there a butene 2 enol the name of this compound is butene 2 enol like that we come to the next example in this example two aldehyde groups are there you should be concentrated illinda start madbeka number ingo adva illinda start madbeka annadu nimge doubt irutte start madbekagirutto I'll choose from this because the second carbon which is attached to the methyl group substituent attach agiruvanta carbon ge least number barutte ikkada inda tagondre adhe ikkada inda tagondre the substituent which is attached to carbon get the 3 number it is bigger than the 2 therefore the numbering we are going to be given from the, this side 1 2 3 4 the name of this compound is second carbon which is attached to the substituent methyl group therefore 2-methyl then number of carbon atoms in the parent chain is 4 therefore butene then we are going to be taken as a 2 functional group is there that is diol that is the name of this compound we are going to be taken as 2-methyl butene 1,4-diol that is 1,4 diol because 2 groups are there the first carbon is a functional group and fourth carbon is a functional group which is the therefore the name of this compound is 2-methyl butene 1,4-diol this is about the name of this compound then this comes to the next example this is the cyclohexane E is going to be which is attached to the that is the aldehyde group that is CHO therefore the E is going to be replaced by the that is AL the name of this compound is that is cyclohexanol the name of this compound is cyclohexanol this is about the nomenclature of the aldehydes idralli e na replace e na a indra replace martive inda a a inda replace martive therefore the abc nomenclature of aldehydes is alcohol few examples we are discussed like this one we will go for the next nomenclature of the ketones